Hello all. In this video, I cover minimum oil circuit breaker. So, minimum oil circuit breaker. Before I discuss the minimum oil circuit breaker, I want to differentiate between bulk oil circuit breaker and minimum oil circuit breaker. This is the bulk oil circuit breaker. This is a picture of the bulk oil circuit breaker. In this bulk oil circuit breaker, whatever the oil, mineral oil. Generally, mineral oil used in the circuit breaker. So this in the circuit breaker, oil, the quantity of oil. So the quantity of oil is more. So that this circuit breaker is called bulk oil circuit breaker. So what are the disadvantages of the bulk oil circuit breaker? Generally, the circuit breaker will be like this. This is the incoming line, for example, 20 amps, and the current passes through this one. And again, current passes through the outgoing terminal like this. Whenever fault occurs, the relay will give the information. Relay will give the information to the circuit breaker, and the contacts will be pulled downwards. This is fixed contact and this is moving contact. Between the fixed and moving contact, arc will be developed, and then between the two contacts, oil will be filled. So then what will happen? The arc will be neutralized by forming the hydrogen gas, H2 gas. So we know, as we know that H2 gas is having a best cooling properties. That's why the arc will be extinguished or arc will be quenched. But as we know that this is having more oil, so that cost and maintenance cost is more, so additional cost is required, more cost is required, and also due to the having high bulk oil, there is a chance of getting fire. So that there is a huge blast will be takes place by using the mineral oil. This is a bulk oil circuit breaker. Next, maintenance problem. There is a maintenance problem because frequently we should maintain the circuit breaker. Regularly we need to check the performance of the circuit breaker, and regularly we should check the oil behavior, oil function. So this is because bulk oil is there now. So that there is a huge problem, huge damage will be takes place to the entire system. So that regular maintenance is required. That's why to overcome the above problems, we should use a minimum oil circuit breaker. So minimum oil circuit breaker having less oil compared to that one. Minimum oil circuit breaker having less oil. This having less oil. And also due to the having less oil, space is less, space requirement is less, and the cost is less, and the maintenance also less, and operation also very fast. So whatever the mineral oil which is using, so the mineral oil is having good insulating properties and cooling properties. So once for example, this is fixed contact, another one is moving contact. Between the these two contact, arc will be formed. This arc will be neutralized by the mineral oil. Whenever the mineral oil will react with the fire, whenever the mineral oil react with the arc, then because of these two, hydrogen gas will be formed. This hydrogen gas is having good cooling properties. So as we know all that arc is nothing but more heat. So immediately we should reduce that heat. So that's why mineral oil is used, because it's having good insulating properties and also cooling property. Whenever the oil is react with the arc, then H2 gas is formed. H2 gas is having good cooling properties. So next one is a mineral oil is used as a arc pinching media. Arc pinching media is nothing but arc extinguishing properties having. This oil having arc extinguishing properties. so that this oil is used to pinch the arc. Pinch the arc is nothing but to eliminate the arc. Whenever arc is formed, it decomposes the oil into the hydrogen gases. As already discussed, I have said that one. Whenever oil react with the arc, then because of these two reactions, oil and the arc reaction will result as a hydrogen gas. Let us look at the construction of the minimum oil circuit breaker. So this is a minimum oil circuit breaker. It's having three chambers. One is top chamber. This is the first one is top chamber, and the second one is a circuit breaker chamber. The second one is circuit breaker chamber, and another one is at the bottom supporting chamber. There are three chambers are there. So let us discuss one individually. First one is supporting chamber. This is the, let us discuss this one, supporting chamber. The supporting chamber is having physical mechanism. So which is here you can see this pulling rod. So whenever relay gives the information, so until the information is given by the relay, circuit breaker will not open or close. So if the circuit breaker cannot open automatically, that is opened by using the signal which is from the relay. So when the relay is given to the signal to the circuit breaker, then only circuit breaker will be opened. So for example, in a system, maximum allowing capacity is 20 amps. For example, 22 amps is flowing now. This is nothing but a huge current and is a heavy current. Because of this one, load will be damaged. So this high current will be sensed by the relay. And relay will give the information to the circuit breaker, and the circuit breaker will be opened. Circuit breaker will be opened with physical mechanism. This is nothing but a totally correlated one. Relay and circuit breaker will be correlated ones. How the relay will be opened, how the relay will pull the circuit breaker. So all those will be discussed in the latter, but this is the operation will be available in the circuit breaker. So this is the mechanism. Here, this is nothing but a moving contact. So this is moving contact, whatever I shared. This is moving contact, and this is the fixed contact. So in the normal condition, both are will be in contact position. In the abnormal condition, both will be opened. Whenever the information is given by the relay, then the circuit breaker will be opened. Opening of the contact will be like that, and fixed contact will be like this, moving contact will be like this. There is a gap between these two. Now, this is supporting chamber also having oil. Circuit breaker chamber also having oil. Both are filled with the oil with the different sub partitions. And this total minimum oil circuit breaker is a protected with porcelain. So outside you can see this, just like this one, the steps in the step model is there. This is porcelain. This is porcelain protection. Nothing but whenever the lightning takes place, it won't allow any current through it. It is act as a insulator. So this rod will, operating rod will interrelation with the nothing but it coordinate with the relay. Whenever the information is given by the relay, then the operating rod will pull the moving contact towards the downward. So this is nothing but a total supporting chamber. Next one is a circuit breaker chamber. If you take circuit breaker chamber is having moving contact. So circuit breaker chamber is having also moving contact is there for the circuit breaker chamber. And arc extinction device. This is arc extinction device. Whenever arc will form, arc extinction device will come into picture, and between the two fixed contact and moving contact, oil will flow, then arc will be fringed. So this is just like a symbol will be like this. This is nothing but a, this is a moving contact, this is fixed contact. between these two arc extinction chamber. Nothing but arc extinction device will be there. This is arc extinction device will be there. So whenever in the normal condition current flows like this, current flows from this is terminal to the circuit breaker and again another terminal. Like this current will flows in the normal condition, both fixed contact and moving contact, both will be in contact mode. This is the normal condition. In the abnormal condition, whenever excess current flows through the terminal 1 to terminal 2, between these two terminals, circuit breaker will be provided. Whenever high current flows through the circuit breaker, relay will be operates. Relay will be available between these two circuit breaker and terminals. This relay will be relay will sense the high current and that will give the information to the circuit breaker and that will pull the this operating rod. And after that one, we can see the while pulling the moving contact towards the downward, arc will be formed. So this is fixed contact and moving contact, between these two arc will be formed. And this is arc will be available in the oil, mineral oil. This is available in the mineral oil. So mineral oil is react with the arc and hydrogen gas will be formed. So thus hydrogen gas will be with high pressure, hydrogen gas will be released and that will be sent to the outside. So that is nothing but a gas vent. This is top chamber. This top chamber is used to fill the oil again. And whenever the compression expansion takes place of the oil, and this top chamber will operate just like a surge tank. This is breather. Whenever gas will be sent outside, again it will consume the nothing but it will absorb the air from the outside like that. It will operate. So this is total about the minimum oil circuit breaker and its function. So the practical view of the minimum oil circuit breaker will be like this. So the practical view of the minimum oil circuit breaker in the substation appears in this way, in this model. So every RYB, every phase is having the different types of circuit breaker. Is R phase circuit breaker, CBR, CBY, CBB, like that. Each circuit breaker is having, circuit breaker is designed for only single phase only. That's why that circuit breaker appears in this way. So this is all about minimum oil circuit breaker.